What is going on, guys? Grave here. Today we got an in-game update for Black Ops Cold War. This is a very small update with one very big change. Before I get into that, make sure if you're not subscribed to the channel to click the subscribe button. I really would appreciate it. And if you are a subscriber, make sure you have notifications turned on. That way you get notified when all my videos go live. And be sure to check out everything down in the description, the community Discord, my Twitter, and of course the affiliate here on the channel, GT Racing. Now that that's out of the way, let's go ahead and hop into this update news. Like I said, you don't have to download anything. This is going to be an in-game update. It's going to download automatically when you turn the game on. Of course, you'll see that little, you know, download bar fill up. It'll be a really quick download, nothing big, nothing like that. But the one really big change with this is they have decided to increase weapon XP earn rates for both multiplayer and zombies. As we all know, the XP earn rates to rank up a weapon in multiplayer and zombies was really, really slow. And of course, you know, today we had the end of the double XP and the double weapon XP, and there was a lot of players, you know, on Twitter, Reddit, that kind of thing, talking about how they were just dreading going back to that normal earn rate for weapons. So Treyarch has been listening. They said they have changed this. They have gone ahead and updated that XP earn rate from what it was when the game was first released. So hopefully this will be a little bit quicker process. I mean, of course, everything's going to feel slow today after earning so much double XP for the last week. But overall, hopefully, that weapon XP grind will not be as bad as it was previously. And hopefully, it'll be a little bit quicker to rank up some of these weapons in-game. Also today, they said they fixed an issue in Nuketown 84 multiplayer that closed an out-of-bounds gap that allowed players to stay alive outside of the playable space. I'm not 100% sure what area this was. They did not go into any specifics, but that was fixed for multiplayer. Also, they addressed an issue where the Napalm Burst Ammo mod was not consistently awarding weapon XP when it was equipped in zombies. And also, they said they addressed an issue that caused lower than targeted weapon XP in solo matches and in later rounds. They said to thank everyone in zombies. They said they know it had been a big issue in zombies with the weapon XP. They said they are planning on doing more double weapon XP events and more double XP events in December. Just like I said, to thank everyone for their patience with the issues they were having in zombies this past week, you know, with the XP event. Anyway, guys, leave me a comment with your thoughts. Like I said, I think that update today of, you know, adding that change to, you know, the weapon XP earn rate is going to be a big one. Hopefully, it's going to be enough to not make it feel like just an absolute crawl. Maybe it'll be a little bit more of a faster pace to unlock a lot of these attachments for these guns. And of course, if you like the video, make sure you hit the like. And I'll catch you all next time. Peace.